أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد أفضل صلواتك بعدد معلوماتك وبارك وسلم وصل عليه أتأمرون الناس بالبر Do you people enjoin others to do good وتنسون أنفسكم and you forget yourselves وأنتم تتلون الكتاب while you recite the scripture أفلا تعقلون have you then no sense وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ وَاسْتَعِينُوا and seek help بِالصَّبْرِ وَاسْتَعِينُوا and seek help بِالصَّبْرِ with sabr وَالصَّلَاةِ and with prayer وَاسْتَعِينُوا بِالصَّبْرِ and seek help of Allah سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى بِالصَّبْرِ with sabr patience وَالصَّلَاةِ and with prayer. So patience here, it means fasting. In a hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, وَهُوَ الشَّهْرُ الصَّبْرُ that Ramadan is the month of patience. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing the Jew people to believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The hindrance in this regard was two things. Number one, wealth. Number two, power. They were of the view, if we will believe in the message of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we will lose power and we will lose wealth. So they were in need of some treatment to treat their nature. Now, lust of power, you may treat it with prayer, because when you will be putting your head on ground, yes, so your nature will be getting transformed. Your nature will be getting transformed. From thinking of yourself very high, you will be thinking of very humble. Got it? And number two, lust of wealth. The treatment is fasting, because through fasting you are controlling your desires. Yes? وَاسْتَعِينُوا and seek help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala بِالصَّبْرِ with sabr, patience. وَالصَّلَاةِ and with prayer. So two meanings. Either patience is meant itself, patience as that is known to you, or by patience as we meant fasting. وَإِنَّهَا لَكَبِيرَةٌ and this is extremely heavy إِلَّا عَلَى الْخَاشِعِينَ except for those who have the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. خشوع means someone who is submitting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with fear. Submissiveness with fear. Got it? Allazina, they are those yazunnuna who believe annahum mulaqu rabbihim, that they are going to meet their Lord. Wa annahum ilayhi raji'un, and that unto him they are going to return. Who are those who are submissive to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with fear? They are those who have a strong belief in the day of judgment, who
who have strong belief?
الَّذِينَ those يَظُنُّونَ who believe certainly أَنَّهُمْ مُلَاقُو رَبِّهِمْ that they are going to meet their Lord وَأَنَّهُمْ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ and that to him they are going to return.
So they have a belief in the day of judgment that they would be put to accountability.
Ya bani Israel, or children of Israel, uskuru ne'mati. Remember my favor, allati that one al-ghamtu alaykum, which I bestowed upon you. Wa anni faddaltukum, and that I preferred you alal ghalameel. I preferred you alal ghalameel.
To the people of your time. I preferred you to the people of your time. That is not a general concept that I have given you preference over all people all the time. No, I preferred you to people of your time. Got it? Because I sent messengers to you. I have sent messengers to you, and that is the basic preference which was given to Jew.
Ya bani Israel, and O children of Israel, uskuru ne'mati. Remember my favor, allati that one anghamtu alaykum, which I bestowed upon you, wa anni fazzaltukum, and I have given you preference alal alami to the people of your time. Wattaqu yawman, and fear a day, la tajzi nafsun an nafsin shay'a, when no person shall avail another anything. وَلَا يُقْبَلُ مِنَا شَفَاتٌ nor will intercession be accepted from him. وَلَا يُخَذُ مِنَا غَدْلٌ nor will compensation be taken from him. وَلَا هُمْ يُنصَرُونَ nor will they be helped.
So as I told you, that people are getting help or support through one of the three means. Through one of the three means. Number one, intercession by big shot. Intercession by big shot. Number two, ransom or bribe and compensation. Ransom or bribe and compensation. And number two, number three, group of supporters. Number three, group of supporters. So these are the three means. When somebody is in situation, either he approaches a big shot to intercede for, yes, or he pays something as a ransom or compensation, got it, or a bribe, or his supporters come forward and they help him, got it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, on the day of judgment, none of these three means will exist. So in worldly life, these are the only three means people are getting support and help through.
وَاتَّقُوا يَوْمًا and fear a day, لَا تَجْزِي نَفْسٌ عَنْ نَفْسٍ شَيْئًا when a person shall not avail another one anything, وَلَا يُقْبَلُ مِنَا شَفَاعَةً nor will intercession be accepted from him. وَلَا يُوْخَذُ مِنَا غَدْلٌ nor will compensation be taken from him. وَلَا هُمْ يُنصَرُونَ nor will they be helped. وَإِذَ نَجَّيْنَاكُمْ مِنَا لِفِرْغَوْنَ
now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding them some of his favors he has done to them in past. The first one,
وَإِذَ نَجَّيْنَاكُمْ and remember نَجَّيْنَاكُمْ when we delivered you and rescued you مِنْ آلِ فِرْغَوْنَ from the people of Pharaoh.
From the people of Pharaoh.
يَسُمُونَكُمْ سُوَ الْغَزَابِ who were afflicting you with a horrible torment.
Who were afflicting you with a horrible torment.
يُذَبِّحُونَ أَبْنَاكُمْ killing your sons,
mean your youth. He was killing your youth because he was afraid of the youth revolution. He was afraid of the youth revolution from 16 to 45. They do not allow them to enter to Baitul Maqdis for prayer even. Got it? That is the old strategy used against them, then they are using it against their opponents.
وَإِذَ نَجَّيْنَاكُمْ مِنْ آلِ فِرْعَوْنَ And remember when we delivered you مِنْ آلِ فِرْعَوْنَ From people of Pharaoh يَسُومُونَكُمْ سُوَ الْعَذَابِ Who were afflicting you with a horrible torment يُزَبِّحُونَ أَبْنَاكُمْ Killing your son وَيَسْتَحْيُونَ نِسَاكُمْ And sparing your woman وَفِي ذَلِكُمْ بَلَاءٌ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ عَظِيمٌ And therein was a mighty trial from your Lord.
Or a big test. There was a big test from your Lord. Got it? And bala is also a favor. And there was a big favor from your Lord. That was a big favor from your Lord.
وَإِذْ فَرَقْنَا بِكُمُ الْبَحْرَ And remember when we separated the sea for you people فَأَنْجَيْنَاكُمْ And we saved you وَأَغْرَقْنَا آلَ فِرْعَوْنَ And drowned the people of Pharaoh وَأَنْتُمْ تَنْظُرُونَ While you were looking at them that they are getting drowned.
That they are getting drowned. You crossed over the sea, Mediterranean, and they got drowned therein. So that is favor number two.
وَإِذْ وَاعَدْنَا مُوسَىٰ أَرْبَعِينَ لَيْلَةً And remember when we appointed for Moses 40 nights.
Yes, to pray at night and fast at daytime. Pray at night and fast at daytime. And he was in seclusion in Mount Tur. He was in seclusion in Mount Tur.
وَإِذْ وَاغَدْنَا مُوسَىٰ And remember when we appointed for Musa 40 لَيْلَةً 40 nights ثُمَّ اتَّخَذْتُمُ الْعِجْلَىٰ And then you took الْعِجْلَىٰ The calf.
The baby cow. What? The baby cow, the calf. L is silent. Professor, is it?
Calf.
Calf. No, L is silent or pronounced? C-A-L-F. Yes. No, so it means that L is silent. Yes.
وَإِذْ وَاغَدْنَا مُوسَىٰ أَرْبَعِينَ لَيْلَةً ثُمَّ اتَّخَذْتُمُ الْعِجْلَىٰ And then you took the calf of the, or the baby cow for worship. مِنْ بَعْدِ after his going to Tur وَأَنْتُمْ ظَالِمُونَ And you were the wrongdoers.
You were the wrongdoers.
How and why they started worshipping cow? Because of three things. Number one, they lived in Egypt for a long time. And in Egypt culture, they used to worship cow.
They used to worship cow.
And their culture was dominant. So that's why the children of Israel were affected by their dominant culture.
Even once they asked Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, اجعل لنا إلهًا كما لهم آلهة, that we need a visible God as the people of Egypt have. We are worshipping invisible God. Yes. So give us a visible God. Musa alayhi salatu wasalam was looking at them. Are you crazy? What are you talking about? Dominant culture, it affects. Dominant culture, it affects. And that's what we the Muslim are doing as well. Because here the non-Muslim culture is dominant. Is it or not? So we are looking at them and we are getting impressed. You are getting impressed. You know what I am saying? Even a Muslim lady 2-3 years before, she called me that we cannot make a model of Kaaba here to make a tawaf around it. Got it? Another lady, she used to call me that I have committed sin and I want to come to you and to confess. I said, confess to Allah. There is no any concept of confession in Islam. Got it? But, yes, there is a good excuse. The dominant culture is a non-Muslim culture and we do not know our own and we are getting impressed by their culture. You're getting? That's human nature. That is what? That's human nature. Where the Muslim culture is dominant, there the non-Muslim are speaking and talking in the same way as Muslims are speaking. Yes, in our area, the Hindus, they are speaking like Muslims. Yes, they are saying Alhamdulillah and Mashallah and Subhanallah. You know what I'm saying? You will be thinking that he's a good Muslim. While he is not, he is a Hindu. But there the Muslim culture is dominant, so that's why they got impressed. You know what I'm saying? So that's why sometime I say that, look, living in Muslim culture, you as a parent, you do not need that many efforts to make for your own kids, because culture itself is controlling them. Culture itself is controlling them. If you do not, Brother Nuruddin, he will be looking at your son. What are you doing? Yes. Because he will be having a reservation in his mind that now he will tell my dad in Salat-e Asr. Yes, so he says, sorry, uncle. That's why there the kids are not doing something wrong in front of a strange elder even. He does not know, but he does not do something wrong. Yes, when you are walking there, yes, you as an imam or you are as a sheikh, you are, yes, the youngsters, what? The youngsters, clean shave, they have their cigarette in their hand, but the moment they will see you, yes, they take it to their back. Yes, in our area, yes, that is culture. That youngsters, yes, youngsters, they do not have the taqiyya, the hat or the turban or something to cover their head. Yes, but when they are coming to their elder, so if nothing is there, so they bring out their, yes. Got it? They do or not? Yes. Got it? So it means that culture itself is a control. Yes? So there you do not need that many efforts. But when you are living in non-Muslim dominant culture, then that is not less than jihad. That is not less than jihad. Then you have to be very reserved and very conservative and things like that. If you are conservative, it will control your kids, otherwise not. You know what I'm saying? But we are thinking other way around, that we are living here, let them do it. Culture itself is taking them anywhere. You know what I'm saying? And you have left their reins as well. So they will go.
وَإِذْ وَاغَدْنَا مُوسَىٰ أَرْبَعِينَ لَيْلَةً. And remember when we appointed for Musa 40 nights.
So, in worshipping of that calf, or baby cow, there were three things involved. Number one, Egyptian culture of worshipping cow. So children of Israel got impressed by. Number two, love of gold. And that baby calf was made of gold. It was made by Yasamiri of what? Of gold. And number three, he made it in such a way that when the wind was entering into, so musical, like musical instrument, rhythm was coming out of. Yes, it was singing like a musical instrument. It was singing like a musical instrument. And they were in love with music. So when all three clubbed together, they said that this is God. Yes, what? This is, as I told you, that in different culture, the concept of God is different. In different cultures, the concept of God is different. As you know, that we, the Muslim, we are using that crescent as our symbol, even though that's not Islamic symbol. You can call it Muslim symbol. You can call it what? Say, that symbol is in Quran. No, that's in Hadith. Prophet ﷺ adopted that. Sahaba invented that. Tabi'een did it. But sometime later the Muslim, yeah, they agreed upon that our symbol will be what? The crescent. Yes, and that's why now these people are propagating that Muslims are worshipping moon god. They are worshipping what? Yes, they are propagating that. That they are worshipping moon god. I say that our great-grandfather Ibrahim, yes, he demolished all these concepts. that there is no star god, no moon god, no sun god even, and no sun god.
Yes.
There is no sun god
and no
sun god, S-U-N, sorry, and both. So concept of God is different in different culture. أَفَرَأَيْتَ مَنَ اتَّخَذَ إِلَاهُ هَوَاهُ. Some people, they have placed their evil desires in place of God. They are worshipping their desires as somebody is worshipping Allah or God. Some other people, they are worshipping gold and silver or wealth and richness as somebody is worshipping God. You know what I'm saying? And that what I told you, that we the Muslim, we believe in God, G-O-D. We believe in God, G-O-D. Yes, and other people, they believe in God, G-O-D, with a little bit interval. We believe in God, G-O-D. They believe in G-O-D. Gold
eye. And then after that, we forgave you. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ, so that you might be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِذَا تَيْنَا مُوسَى الْكِتَابَ, and remember when we gave Musa the scripture. وَالْفُرْقَانَ, and the criterion.
Furqan mean? The criterion.
لَعَلَّكُمْ تَعْتَدُونَ, so that you may be guided aright. وَإِذَ قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِ, and remember when Musa told his people, يَا قَوْمِ, O my people, إِنْ لَكُمْ ظَلَمْتُمْ أَنفُسَكُمْ, you have wronged yourself, بِاتِّخَاذِكُمُ الْعِجْلَى, by worshipping the baby cow,
by worshipping the baby cow.
فَتُوبُوا إِلَى بَارِكُمْ, so turn in repentance to your creator.
Bar imana, creator.
Faqtulu anfusakum,
literal meaning is kill yourselves. Kill yourselves. Even though if Allah or messenger of Allah will order something which is prohibited otherwise, so it becomes lawful then. It becomes lawful then. Is making sajda to somebody else other than Allah, that is prohibited. Yes? But when Allah said to the angels that make a sajda to Adam, they did it, that was obedience. Iblis did not, that was disobedience. Got it? Because what is lawful and what is unlawful, that is coming from the authority. Yes, certain things are legal. When authority in Washington DC, they said that now no more. So if you will do that, you would be charged for. You know what I'm saying? That is the case of Allah. When Allah says this is lawful, go ahead, do that. When he says unlawful, stop. Abstain from. Got it? So this is literal meaning. But this is not meant here. This is not meant here. From every tribe, some people, they worship the baby cow. From every tribe, some people, they worship the baby cow. And the Jew culture is a tribal culture. Jew culture is tribal culture. Their 12 tribes are very well known. They say one of that got lost. And that's why they do claim us, that you are our cousins. Yes. Yes, they are asking through UNO that we want to take DNAs of certain tribes of Pashtuns to find out that they are our cousins. Yes, so they are the Germans, they said that they are ours because they are Aryans. They say they are our cousins because they are Aryans. So anyhow, their culture was a tribal culture. Yes, and in tribal culture, if somebody will kill a person from another tribe, that will become a feud of what? Tribes. A feud of what? Tribes. So that's why, as a diplomacy, Allah ordered Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, those who worshipped the baby cow from one tribe, their own people should kill them. Their own people should kill them, otherwise it will create a turmoil. Even though the base is there, the messenger ordered us to kill that guy. Oh, you killed our guy, we will burn your house. Yes? And tribal culture is thing like that. We are tribes, so that's why we know it. Yes. We are tribal because you cannot live without that. Alone and alone, you cannot take a step that this is wrong. Yes, you will be going with your tribe, or you have to leave the area. Or you have to leave the area and go somewhere else. As long as you are living there with your own tribe, so do whatever the Roman do. Yes? Got it? Living in Rome? Yes. So in tribal culture is thing like that? Oh, yes, he insulted a man of my tribe. He is from other tribe. We have a historical enmity with each other. He did it purposely. Maybe he has done by way of mistake. But because of the tribal culture, yes, we explain it other way around. He did it because sometime back there was an enmity between our tribe and his tribe. Got it? Now in their tribal area, when these groups are fighting with each other, these groups are fighting. Yes, both of them, they are claiming that we are good Muslims and we want to implement Islam, but they are killing each other. Why? Because someone from this tribe has been killed by the people of other tribe. Yes. So now Islam is in the background. Now go ahead and take revenge. That's what tribal culture is. So look, what a best diplomacy that was. What a good diplomacy that was. What? That those who worship the baby cow, they should be killed by the people of their own tribe, not by the people of other tribe. It will create a big turmoil. So faqtulu anfusakum e ikhwanakum min qabilatikum. Ikhwanakum min qabilatikum. Your brothers from your own tribes. Your brothers from your own tribes.
وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ and remember when Musa said to his people, يَا قَوْمِ O my people, إِنْ لَكُمْ ظَلَمْتُمْ verily you have wronged yourselves بِاتِّخَاذِكُمُ الْعِجْلَ by worshipping the calf. فَتُوبُوا إِلَى بَارِئِكُمْ so turn in repentance to your creator. فَقْتُلُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ so kill your brothers from your own tribes.
The innocent may kill the wrongdoers. The innocents may kill the wrongdoers.
Zalikum khairul lakum, that is better for you or best for you, in the barakum with your Lord, fataba alaykum, and then he accepted your repentance. Innahu at-tawwabur rahim, truly he is the one who accept repentance and the most merciful. Wa iz qultum ya Musa lan nu'mina laka,
Musa alayhi salatu wasalam took their elders with him to Sina, took them to Sinai desert. And when Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, he spoke to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So these people said to Musa, O Musa, can we see Allah face to face? We want to look at him. We want to look at him. And that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala referred to when these Jew people said to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, ke we cannot believe in your message, but if you will bring us a written book as Musa brought. Because Musa brought an inscribed book. It was in written shape. It was in written shape. Our Prophet ﷺ was receiving Holy Quran verbally through Jibreel. So Jew people said that we cannot believe it. But if you will bring us a written book. You know what I'm saying? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala countered their demand. But ask them that Musa brought a written book, what you people did with him? Yes. Musa brought you people a written book. What you did with him? You were not satisfied with. You were asking him, show us Allah face to face. Show us Allah face to face. So your questions do not have any end. Your questions do not have. Khui badra bahana bisyar. Khui badra bahana bisyar. Bad habit has a lot of excuses. Yes. Khoi badra bahana bisyar means? Say. Yes. Bad habits have a lot of excuses. Yes. We will address one excuse, you will bring another one. Then we will address another one, so you will bring a third one. Then we will bring another one, then you will bring a fourth one. It will be going on. So the best thing is, just keep quiet with the first excuse.
وَإِذْ قُلْتُمْ يَا مُوسَى لَنْ نُؤْمِنَ لَكَ. And when you said, O Musa, لَنْ نُؤْمِنَ لَكَ, we shall never believe in you, حَتَّى نَرَى اللَّهَ جَارَةً, till we see Allah plainly and openly.
Till we see Allah plainly and openly. So you were asking for such a thing which you could not carry, which you could not carry, which you couldn't bear, that is beyond your power. Looking at Allah, that was beyond your power. If somebody will ask for such a thing which he cannot do, ultimate result will be destruction. Yes or not? If somebody, he does not know how to drive a car, and he will ask you that, give me your car, I want to drive it, and you will give it to him, what will be the result?
Destruction.
Yes. Destruction of not himself only. The car is gone. Yes? Got it? I do not know how to fly. If I will ask the pilot that, give me 777. So what will be the ultimate end? Destruction. Because that is beyond my power and beyond my ability. Yes? Got it? So never ask something which is beyond your power and beyond your ability. And never promise for such a thing which you cannot do. As Huzaifa ibn al-Yaman radiyallahu ta'ala an, he said that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا ينبغي لمؤمن أن يذل نفسه. This is not good for a true believer to put himself down. This is not good for a true believer to put himself down. قالوا أو رجل يذل نفسه. They said, is there anyone who will be putting himself down? Everybody is putting himself up, not down. So is there anyone who will be putting himself down? Prophet said, أن يتعرض لما لا يطيق. When he offers himself for something which he cannot do. When he offers himself for such a thing which he cannot do. So in the end, people, brother, you promise that I will do that. Yes, so that will be humiliation. Who is humiliating him? He himself humiliated himself. He himself humiliated himself. Yes, he should have said, no, sorry, I cannot do that. Sorry, I cannot do that. Got it? Sometime because of haya we say a thing, but that is not good. We should say at the moment that, Sheikh, yes, but I don't think that I am able to do that. Got it? Professor, is it good? Is it good or not? Yes.
وَإِذْ قُلْتُمْ يَا مُوسَىٰ لَنْ نُؤْمِنَ لَكَ حَتَّىٰ نَرَى اللَّهَ جَارَةً till we see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala plainly فَأَخَذَتْكُمُ السَّائِقَةُ فَأَخَذَتْكُمُ السَّائِقَةُ so you were seized with a thunderbolt.
You were seized with what? With a thunderbolt.
وَأَنْتُمْ تَنْظُرُونَ while you were looking at that. Summa ba'asnakum.
So they got killed with thunderbolt.
Summa ba'asnakum.
But that was not the time of their appointed death. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought them back to life.
Summa ba'asnakum min ba'di mawtikum. And then we raise you up after your death. La'allakum tashkurun. So that you might be grateful to Allah. وَظَلَّلْنَا عَلَيْكُمُ الْغَمَامَ and we shaded you with clouds.
Because when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala destroyed Pharaoh and his people, yes, and children of Israel, they were looking at their gardens, their cultivated crops, cultivated fields, cultivated farms and ranches, and their castles. They were very much happy. Now we will have that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered Musa alayhi salatu wa salam, take them back to the holy land. Their ancestors' land. What? Their ancestors' land to Palestine. So Musa alayhi salatu wasalam asked them to go there. So they said, no, we cannot go there. Why? They said, inna fiha qawman jabbareen. The tribes who are living there and they occupied that area, they are fighters. They are what? They are very strong in fight. If we will go there, they will kill all of us. There were so many tribes. Kenani was there, Arami was there, Philistine was there, Fenaki was there, Amalekites were there. All of them, they were fighter tribes. So children of Israel, they were very much afraid of these tribes because they got developed in clutches of slavery. They got developed in clutches of slavery. Got it? And slave, he does not know what freedom means. Slave does not know what freedom means. He is very much content with what he is, with slavery. So for centuries, they were in slavery. So that's why they were not thinking of that to go and to fight for their own right. Got it? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَإِنَّهَا مُحَرَّمَةٌ عَلَيْهِمْ أَرْبَعِينَ سَنَاءً. They cannot live inside Egypt. Take them to Sinai Desert. Take them to Sinai Desert. So when they came to Sinai Desert, so there was nothing to eat. There was nothing to eat. So فَانْزَلْنَا عَلَيْكُمُ الْمَنَّ وَالسَّلْوَىٰ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala provided them with sweet gum and with quails. With sweet gums and what? With quails for eating. There was no drinking water. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered Musa alayhi salatu wasalam to hit the rock with his staff, and 12 fountains were gushing forth. Still, 7 of them are gushing forth, but the water is no more usable. Got it? 7 out of 12 are still alive, but there are a lot of weeds and so it means that now that water is not usable. So that is number 2. And number 3, in desert, there was no shade. So at daytime, in summer, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used to bring clouds over them to shade them. Clouds over them to shade them. So these 3 favors were given to children of Israel in Sinai Desert.
وَظَلَّلْنَا عَلَيْكُمُ الْغَمَامَ, and we shadowed over you, الْغَمَامَ, the clouds. وَانْزَلْنَا عَلَيْكُمُ الْمَنَّ, and we sent down over you, الْمَنَّ, the sweet gum. وَالسَّلْوَى, and the quails. كُلُوا مِنْ طَيِّبَاتِ مَا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ, eat of the fair things we have given you. وَمَا ظَلَمُونَا, and they have not wronged you, وَلَكِنْ كَانُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ يَظْلِمُونَ, but they wronged themselves.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله محمد وآله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم ربنا ارحمنا بالقرآن العظيم, ونزكنا بالقرآن ما نسي.